Tony Agana, number 9 Richard Cadet, number 10 Mark Dempsey, number 11 Peter Beagrie, and the substitutes number 12 Colin Morris and number 14 Chris Downs. This afternoon's referee is Mr. Kelvin Morton from Bury St. Edmunds. United playing in their usual red and white striped shirts, with Hull in their usual yellow amber tops with red and black trim. So it will be Hull to kick off, Gareth Roberts and Billy Askew. A game which is very important for both sides. The Tigers have slipped down to 8th and are desperate to get back into the top few, while United, under new manager Dave Bassett, are trying to avoid the drop into the relegation zone. So United start with a throw on the far side. Good header from Jobson, but offside. Richard Jobson came running in and planted a beautiful header through. There was two men on the far side. Sadly, Lee Jenkinson was offside. So a free kick to United. Jenkinson, just 19 years old, replacing Neil Williams, who has been suffering with blisters on his foot for most of the week. And a free kick to United. Billy Askew fouling Mark Dempsey. Parker chasing. Smith plants it back in. And a throw to United. Laid off nicely. Agana. Saville held it off nicely for Parker. This is Askew. Marvellous ball outside to Lee Jenkinson. Now, and Jenkinson just kicking the ball too far, making his full debut. He's had two previous substitute appearances, Lee Jenkinson. Goal kick to Sheffield United. Sand has been added to the ground here at Boothbury Park. Pretty cut up after the recent bad weather. And both goal mouths on the centre of the field have had sand added to it. And Tony Norman keeps the ball in play. Beagrie, Jobson clears for Hull. Dyer chasing. Smith for United. And he kept his head well, Brian Smith. Todd. Still Todd. He did well to get the ball out, but Palmer there for Hull. And the free kick to Sheffield United. Brian Smith will take it. Palmer for Hull. Dyer. Well brought down. Jobson did well and has earned Hull a free kick. Jenkinson. Heard. Cleared by Smith. Heard again. Stancliffe clears. Dempsey, good ball outside here to Beegree. Beegree, two men on him. Well, that extra man, one too many for Peter Beegree, and it will be a Hull throw. Garner looking for Cadet. Beegree, strong challenge by Parker. This is Roberts. Palmer, interception by Todd. Beegree, the ex-Middlesbrough player, he's got the better of Palmer. And Hull have a free kick. Sheffield United have quite a following with them to this game, despite being 19th in the second division. A number of fans have travelled across to Hull. The block by Roberts. Goes out of play for a United throw. Referee having a word with one of his linesmen. And he's now having a word with Charlie Palmer. I think the linesman spotted an earlier incident between Palmer and Beegree. But play goes on. Roberts. Parker, good ball for Saville. Saville! Good attempted chip by Andy Saville. He saw Andy leaning come off his line. He'd got the better of Brian Smith. And just couldn't quite get the extra bit of height to chip the United keeper. Jenkinson. Smith read that well and has now released Cadet. But Tony Norman is there for the Tigers. Askew, Jenkinson, and Lee Jenkinson wins a corner for Hull. And Andy Barnsley will have to work hard on that far side to contain Jenkinson. Jobson and Skipper up from the back. It's a long corner looking for Jobson. And after Richard Jobson's header, it must have taken a deflection. United have a corner. Sorry, Hull City have a corner. Roberts and Askew behind the ball. Askew with it. Looking for Jobson again. Poor clearance. This is Heard. With Andy Saville offside. And United have a free kick. Roberts. Parker beats Todd in the air. Agana trying to release Cadet. Norman comes out for Hull. And Andy Saville slowly getting back onside. Too long for Beagrey. Jobson has to give away. And it's a throw to United. So Pike to take the long throw. Pike again. Jobson clears and Askew helps it on. Todd. No one there but Heard. Askew. Jenkinson onside. Now Lee Jenkinson. And Lee Jenkinson had the chance to put Hull in front. A shot was on the cards, but instead he tried to lay the ball across to Dyer. The ball didn't reach him. A chance wasted for City. Amazingly, he stayed onside, only just. And the shot looked on the cards. I'm afraid he tried to cross it to Dyer. Barnsley with the United throw. Heatherstone back to Barnsley. And City lucky. Cadet with the header and Palmer cleared. Todd. United still with possession, but Palmer has won the ball fairly. Pike. Agana. The cross just too long for Peter Heatherstone. The old Watford partnership linking up there. That should be Norman's, and he held on well. But Charlie Palmer beaten by Tony Agana, and Agana's cross just too high for Peter Heatherstone. Dyer, Parker, Saville. Barnsley for United. Heard. Twenty minutes gone. The score still goalless. And they're quite unevenly matched. Opening 20 minutes. City have a free kick. It's a false throw, so City get the chance. It's Saville looking for Dyer. Gareth Roberts arriving. The ball was headed over, and Hull have a corner. Saville given room to turn, and both Dyer and Roberts queuing up for the header. Jobson, good save by Andy Leaning. Jobson had the time to shoot and he placed it perfectly, but Leaning matched him. The ex-York City goalkeeper pulling off a great save. Heard. Cadet. Skipper with the tackle. Heatherstone. Dyer for Hull. Askew to Jenkinson. Saville back to Jenkinson. Neat 1-2 between Jenkinson and Saville. Now, what can he do with the cross? He lays it back to Askew. Askew, Saville! Brilliant save by Andy Leaning. That's the second time the ex-York keeper has been called on to perform a magnificent save. But the United defence stood still as Saville was given the free header. But Leaning performing wonders for United. 39 appearances for York City. Andy Leaning made before United bought him. And Barnsley clears the corner. Roberts for Hull. Keeps it in play. And Leaning survives. Alex Dyer's challenge. Smith is heard for Hull. Jenkinson. Saville. Askew dispossessed by Dempsey. Heatherstone. Skipper clears for the throw. Heatherstone gets the cross in and Heard calmly plays the ball back to Norman. Dyer. Alex Dyer seems to be losing his battle against Brian Smith and Paul Stancliffe. Cadet brought that down nicely, but the double challenge of Skipper and Askew was too much. Heard. Parker. Parker's failing to bring the ball but down. He has another chance. Saville now. Andy Saville. Andy Saville, 28 minutes gone, and Andy Saville proves to manager Brian Horton that he was the right man to wear the number 8 shirt. Saville, who was only on the transfer list only a few days ago, has been brought off the list straight back into the first team and scores 1-0 to Hull City, 28 minutes gone. Andy Saville the scorer. So Hull City take the all-important one-goal lead. And Saville, who came so close with a header only moments ago, finds the back of the net. Heard for Hull. Saville. Back to Askew. Roberts did well. Parker! Gary Parker shot wide of Andy Leaning's upright. Parker, quite a frequent scorer this season. He wasn't far off with that one. Askew for Hull. Free kick to United. Stancliffe with the free kick. Skipper clears. Smith brings it back in. This is Heatherstone. Peter Heatherstone. Off the crossbar. But it's still not cleared. How did United not score? Norman came off his line. Heatherstone tried to chip him. It came off the crossbar. And then United had a second bite at the cherry. But it's not all over yet. Beagrie. He's got the better of Palmer. That should be Tony Norman's. Hull have a free kick, but they were lucky there. Just 2 minutes after Saville had put them in front, Norman came off his line, Heatherstone tried to chip him, and the ball rebounded off the crossbar. Peter Heatherstone, so close with that effort. And he'll be wondering how it didn't go in. Stancliffe has done well in keeping Alex Dyer out of the game in this opening half hour. And the rain now coming down here at Boothroyd Park. It's been very windy, and finally the wind has brought rain with it. This is Beagrie. Cleared. Beagrie again. It's a good ball. Beagrie, and that one too long for Heatherstone. Peter Beagrie, the United player who has stood out so far in this match, has created a number of chances, but Agana and Cadet, the United strikers, have failed to turn those chances into goals. Jobson again comes up from the back. But the free kick was a poor one. Parker outside to Roberts. Neat ball inside to Saville. Roberts. And Stancliffe with the challenge. Another corner to Hull. Jobson with the header. Roberts. Cleared by Smith. Roberts. His ball too long for Andy Saville. Heard. Askew. Heard. Saville out jumped. Heard again for Hull. Cadet. Good challenge by Skipper. Jenkinson onside. Lee Jenkinson. Back to Alex Dyer. Dyer. Should have done better. He had the time, put his shot into the side netting. Jenkinson just staying onside again, laid the ball back, and Dyer's shot wide of Andy Leaning's goal. Into the final 5 minutes of this first half. Hull City leading by 1-0. Andy Saville to score after 28 minutes. This is Beagrie for United. To Pike. Martin Pike letting his concentration just wander for a moment. Dyer. Neat dummy. Parker onside. Gary Parker. Parker. And Parker should have done better. Leaning, providing the save. He'll be a little annoyed with that one. Cadet. Jobson with the challenge. Jobson again. Todd for United. To Beegree. Beegree. He's got the better of Palmer all afternoon. But his cross was poor. Savile for Holland. Parker. Roberts. Dyer. Back to Askew. Billy Askew. And another good save by Andy Leaning. He's in form this afternoon as the United keeper. That's three brilliant saves he's pulled off. And if it wasn't for him, United could be four down. Dyer laid the ball back, and Askew's strike was perfect. But so was Leaning's save. Skipper with the header. United clear. And Palmer with the challenge. Charlie Palmer doing well in holding off Tony Agana. Savile. Roberts. Dyer. Parker. A good ball wide to Hurd. Pat Hurd. With Pat Hurd's concentration wandering, and the ball to Lee Jenkinson going into touch. So United have a throw with Andy Barnsley. Heatherston. Hurd, looking for Dyer. Dyer. Savile now. And a corner to Hull. Andy Savile. Okay. Very effervescent up front this afternoon. And Lee Jenkinson will try again with a corner. Looking for Skipper. Skipper with the header. Andy Savile has scored, but the linesman is flagging. And Savile offside. Skipper did well to win the ball in the first place. Savile's header just looping over Leaning, but he was offside. Playing injury time. And there is the half-time whistle. Hull City lead Sheffield United by 1-0. The goal coming from Andy Savile after 28 minutes. But the hero of the first half is the United keeper, Andy Leaning. Savile had a header well saved by Leaning, and then Askew had a shot just tipped over by the keeper. The half-time score, Hull City 1, Sheffield United 0. Well, will come back for the second half. It's 100 years ago to this season since Sheffield United won the First Division Championship. And sadly, they haven't had much luck trophy-wise since then. And they find themselves 1-0 down here at Boothroyd Park. Andy Saville, the Hull City scorer. Free kick to Hull. Jobson with it. Heatherstone. Heard for Hull. Cadet. Dyer. Back to Askew. Now, Askew. Offside against Lee Jenkinson. Jobson for Hull. Parker up with Todd. This is Askew. Back to Hurd. Dyer with the flick on. And he has earned Hull the free kick. Heard with the free kick. Parker back to Palmer. The linesman flagging on the far side. Mr. Morton, the referee, has gone across to have a word with Mr. Short, the linesman. I think it involves an incident with Hull City fullback Charlie Palmer. Referee is bringing out his book. And the name of Peter Beagrie is going in it. And he's also booking Palmer. Saville, back to Dyer. Roberts. United clear. Hurd. Good header wide to Jenkinson. Jenkinson against Barnsley. Jenkinson. Did well to beat the fullback. This cross went behind. Askew, Beagrie, Palmer for Hull, Askew, Heatherstone, looking for a Garner, Tony Norman slipping for a moment. But thankfully for Hull, he managed to gather the ball. Good ball by Roberts. Now Palmer, plenty of space for Charlie Palmer. He's taken on the fullback. Surely that will be a Hull free kick. He also looks to be calling Paul Stancliffe. And the name of Paul Stancliffe, the Sheffield United captain, looks like being the third name in Mr. Morton's book. Hull have a free kick just outside the penalty area. Roberts, a shot from Gareth Roberts, just wide of the post, and the Hull City captain, who stands at only 5'5", coming close for the Tigers there. So Hull prepare for the corner. Richard Jobson and Peter Skipper have come up from the back. Parker, and Gary Parker's shot wide of the post. Heard. Palmer. Dyer. Parker making the run through midfield. Skipper. Peter Skipper doing well for Hull in the centre of defence. A good partnership Hull have got going there between Skipper and Jobson. So Hull have a free kick. Gary Parker, the England under 21 international, with it. Heatherstone. Jobson clears. Heatherstone. Heatherstone again. Barnsley. Sheffield passing the ball about neatly. But Palmer clears for Hull. Chance for Hull. Sheffield United have scored. The Tigers failing to clear what should have been cleared. And really, that was a dreadful mistake by the Hull defenders. United finally level. They've been posing problems at the start of the second half. And Richard Cadet has put them in front. ...63 minutes gone. Hull City 1, Sheffield United 1. United playing with much more confidence. Hull City making a substitution. Billy Askew, the player coming off. And Andy Payton is coming on. So Hull bring on a striker for a midfielder. Askew seemed to be limping a bit earlier on. Maybe he's taken a knock. Man the United fans are cheering is Richard Cadet. Quite a record, 56 goals in 104 appearances in his time at Southend, and he's now starting knocking in the goals for United too. United fans can finally cheer. A point will be very valuable to them in their bid to pull away from the relegation zone. Agana. Beagrie for United. Pike looking for Beagrie. And the corner given. A tackle by Andy Payton. Hull have a goal kick. Brian Smith at the near post really had a chance to score, but failed to turn the ball in. And all that resulted in a Hull goal kick. Saville. Heard. Now United on the break. Agana. The challenge by skipper Saville to Parker. Parker, good ball wide to Payton. Andy Payton. Still Andy Payton. But Paul Stancliffe blocked his attempted shot. Now what can Charlie Palmer do with the long throw? Todd clears. Skipper. Palmer. Hurd, good effort by Pat Hurd. Just swerving over the top. Payton. Dyer outjumped by Smith. Todd. Heatherston. Agama slipped and Roberts clears. Stanford. Outside to Beegery. Hurd clears. Back to Beegery. Dyer. Offside against Richard Cadet. Todd Cadet got the better of Hurd. Heatherston. Ball inside. Cadet looking for his second. Beegery. And 2-1 to United. Peter Beegery. Perfectly placed. 80 minutes gone in this match. 10 minutes left. And Peter Beegery. He placed that one perfectly. After all the chances Hull City had in the first half, United find themselves in front. He'd been looking dangerous down the far side. He'd caused Charlie Palmer plenty of problems. And now Hull City's unbeaten home record is under threat. Heatherston. Skipper. United fans in full chorus. Smith. Hurd for Hull. Savile. Savile, Payton chasing. Garner. The ball goes into touch. Parker clears. Saville. Payton. Palmer with the whole throw. And Hull City making a second substitution. Gary Parker, the player coming off, he will be replaced by Ray Daniel in a last-ditch attempt. The Tigers trailing by 2-1. Cadets and Beagrie, the United scorers. Saville scored the whole goal. Saville. Heatherstone challenged by Hurd. Dyer. Hurd. Cadet to Heatherstone, to Agana. Beagrie. Outside to Pike. Back to Beagrie, tries a shot. Into the final 5 minutes. Saville. For the game, United clear up across the back. Hurd. Smith for United. Palmer. 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 Too long for Dyer. And time slipping away for Hull. And their promotion hopes going with it. Heatherstone. Skipper clears. Heard. Sheffield United now making a substitution. Colin Morris, the player wanting to come on. And finally does get on in place of striker Richard Cadet. Morris, quite a favourite with the United fans, a long-serving striker. And even though at 34 he's still producing them performances, and here he is. Heard. Saville. Daniel. Good challenge by Morris. Heatherstone. Todd. Roberts. And United have a free kick. Playing injury time here at Boothroyd Park. Jenkinson. Saville. Heatherstone for United. Surely now the chance of a Holly equaliser slipped away. And there is the final whistle. Hull City's hopes of promotion and their unbeaten home record have slipped away here at Boothroyd Park. The Sheffield United fans enjoying a brilliant second half comeback. The final score, Hull City 1, Sheffield United 2.